Good morning, everyone. So our subject name is Theory of Computation, short form is DOC. In this subject or in this course consists 5 units. So in that, the unit number first is finite automata and regular expressions. Unit number second is context free grammar. Unit number three, context free languages. Unit number four, push down automata. And unit number five is the Turing machine and undecidability. So for this subject or for this course, also having reference books. Reference books, first is John C. Martin, Introduction to Languages and Theory of Computation. Second, Introduction to Formal Language and Automata Theory, written by Kamla, author. Then third is Elements of Theory of Computation. Then fourth is Introductory Theory of Computer Sciences. So written by, or the author is Krishnamurti. So these are the reference books prescribed by in our Batu University. Then textbook, name of the textbook is Introduction to Automata Theory, Languages and Computation by Motwani. So this is our structure of Theory of Computation subject. So where it is used in our computation or in our software engineering? It is used for designing the compiler. It is used for the natural language processor. It is also used in deep learning and machine learning. So lots of uses of our Theory of Computation subject in our computer engineering, or we call it a software engineering branch. So we will start our first unit. The name of that unit is nothing but the finite automata and regular expressions. So before directly discussing about the finite automata model, first we have to discuss about the what is the regular language and regular expression. So now we start our unit number one. The name of that unit number one is finite automata and regular expressions. In that, we have to discuss the first point of our first unit of our subject is regular language and regular expressions. So before the starting of regular language and regular expression, we discuss after the learning of regular language and regular expression, what we will achieve. So after the learning of regular language and regular expression, students will be able to understand the concepts of regular language and regular expression. Means you people got the ideas of what is the regular language and regular expression. Along with that, you create a regular language and regular expression of the given statements. So in the exam or the problem is like that, key we have to given a statements, and for that the statements we have to construct the regular language as well as the regular expression. For example, the statements is like that, key strings ending with a zero. So for that the string ending with the zero, we have to create a regular language plus a regular expression of that statement here. So these are the two major outcomes after the learning of regular language and the regular expressions. So let's start regular language and regular expression. So first we discuss about the regular language. So what is the regular language? Which parameter includes into regular language? And how we write the regular language? We have to discuss in regular language part. After that, we will discuss about regular expression. So let me start the discussion on a regular language. Simply, regular language is obtained from three basic languages and the three operations. Means the regular language consists major two components. First component, it consists three basic languages, and the second component we call it is the three operations. So first we have to discuss about the three basic languages. And after that, we will discuss about the which are the three operations we have to implement on these three basic languages. So let me just start from a basic languages. So also there are consist three basic languages. So first language is the null language. So remember one thing, that each and every language we have to represent in curly brackets. Means opening and the closing curly brackets. Likewise, the set. I have to here focus. The prerequisite required for our TOC is nothing but the discrete mathematical structure concepts. So each and every language we have to represent in curly brackets, and we have to separate the strings or alphabet of that language by using comma. So there are the three basic languages which is involved into our regular language. First basic language is null language. So this null language consists element is the null string, or we call it consists the element as a null alphabet along with null strings. So how we represent the null string? So this symbol is represent the null alphabet here. that null alphabet we are denoted by epsilon symbol here. And the null string is nothing but the combination of these symbols only. It is called the null string here. So the first language of regular language is nothing but the null language, and that null language consists the null alphabets along with null strings here. And that null strings we are represented by this symbol, and this symbol we called as a epsilon here. Okay, then second language is nothing but the simple language. The simple language, we have to construct the strings of the simple language by using our alphabets. Alphabets as A, B, C, D, etc. So the simple language consists the strings of the form A, B. So this A, B is nothing but the alphabets. By using that alphabet, we have to form the strings, and that strings or that collection of strings or collection of alphabets along with strings, simple we call it in the simple language. Then third language is nothing but the empty language. That empty language is the third language which is required for the basic languages. So this empty word suggests here ki in this language consists no elements. Means we have to represent that empty language by using only curly brackets. Curly brackets or the symbol is phi. So the phi symbol denotes one kind of language is nothing but the empty language. So these are the three basic languages which is required for our discussion of regular language. I'm just repeating again. So the basic language is nothing but it is the combination of the null language. Null language consists the null alphabets. We denote it by using epsilon. Then second kind of language is a simple language. A simple language, we have to construct the strings over our alphabets, English alphabets, likewise A, B, up to J. Then the third language is nothing but the empty language. The empty language we denote by using open and closing curly brackets, means it consists no any element. Remember one thing, that we have to represent empty language either opening and closing curly brackets or phi. We have to not put phi into open and closing curly brackets. If we are putting phi into open and curly brackets, then it becomes simple language. Why? Because this phi we are treating here is an alphabet. So that's why we have to represent empty language only by open and closing curly brackets or phi. Okay, so this is the first component which is required for our regular language, is nothing but the basic languages. So along with these basic languages also consists of three operations here. So which are these three operations? Let me discuss one by one. So in these three operations, two operations are binary operations, and the one is nothing but the unary operation. So unary operations, we require only one operator for performance operation. Then binary operations, we require two operands for performing that operation. So let me discuss one by one. First is union. Union, we require two regular languages, not regular languages, we call it basic languages. Means the combinations of the two basic languages, we got another kind of regular language, another kind of language that also called as a regular language. Means the first operation is the union, means we have to combine the strings of the two languages. Second, concatenation. That concatenation, sorry, for the union, we represent the symbol U or colon. Then third, sorry, second, concatenation. Concatenation we represent by dot symbol. Just we have to concat the two languages. Means we have to concat each and every strings of the first language to the second language strings here. We got another kind of language, that language becomes a regular language also. So it is the concatenation. We will discuss one by one after in the example part. But remember one thing, that key second operation is nothing but the concatenation, and we represent the concatenation by using the dot part. Then third is nothing but the cleans. Clean we represent by the star here. So star is nothing but we have to repetitively call the alphabets. Means consider we represent a zero. Zero is a single alphabet we call, and we have to make clean operations, or we have to apply clean operation on the zero. So we have to write zero star, and that the zero star consists languages first symbol is null, then zero, then we have to repetitively call zero. Means double zero, triple zero, third time zero, four time zero, up to infinite. So the cleans are not ending in 3, 4 or 5 times. It goes on repetitively called up to infinite part. So these are the three basic languages and the three operations. Means by the combining or the making combining the three basic languages and the three operations, we got one kind of a language, and that language we called as a regular language. So the regular language, three basic languages plus three operations. Three basic languages: null language, simple language, empty language, and three basic operations: union, concatenation, and cleanse. Union we represent by U or comma, concatenation we represent by the dot, and cleanse we represent by the stat. So for example, the regular languages on some basic languages and the operation is likewise. Means we have to keep this null part, means the epsilon, it also becomes one regular language. Single zero into curly brackets also becomes one regular language. 001 also becomes one regular language. 0, 1. In 0 and 1 we have to make a union, or we represent as 00U01. Single opening and closing brackets or null also becomes our regular language, because regular language consists the empty language, which is the one component of our regular language. So these are the some examples of our regular languages. So next we have to discuss about the regular expressions. So regular expressions, we have to construct the regular expression by using the regular languages. So how it is possible? Having majorly two rules here. And that the first rule is nothing but by leaving out the brackets, means curly brackets, or replacing them with the parentheses, means round parentheses. Means we have to replace that curly brackets by round parentheses. It is our first rule. And the second rule, we have to replace union symbol by plus. We got the resultant expression is called as a regular expression. Means we have to require a regular language as input, and by applying these two rules we got one kind of expression, and that expression we simply call as a regular expression. So that the first rule is nothing but we have to remove opening and closing brackets, or we have to replace that opening and closing brackets with round parentheses, which is our first rule. The second rule is nothing but we have to replace the plus symbol or the union symbol, we have to replace union symbol by the plus. We got one kind of regular expression called as a regular expression in a simple way. So how it is possible? So consider here is a regular language. 0 is one of our component in our regular language part. Remember one thing, that already we discussed that we have to represent languages in between opening and closing brackets here. Simply we have to remove that opening and closing brackets. We got an expression. That expression is nothing but regular expression. Now here is 0, 1. Our second rule we have to apply here. Second rule tells us that we have to replace union U or comma by plus sign. Means 0, 1. We have to replace this opening and closing brackets by round parentheses here. Likewise 0, 10. Now 10 now here becomes as a concatenation. Means 1 we have to concat 0 here. So these means there is no rule for the concatenation, means we have to write 0 as it is here. 0 we have to replace that comma by plus, and we have to keep 10 as it is. And second thing, we have to replace the curly brackets by round parentheses. We got a regular expression as 0, 10. Fourth example, 110 we have to keep it is. We have to replace these curly brackets by round parentheses. We have to keep as star as it is. 0, 1. We have to write 0, 1, because comma or U symbol we have to replace by the plus. 0, 1, and we have to replace that opening and closing bracket by round parenthesis. So this is the example of regular expression, how we convert the regular expression by using the regular language and etc. Remember one thing, that regular expression, we have to take regular language and first apply the rule is we have to replace open and closing brackets by round parentheses, and the second rule is nothing but we have to replace union symbol or comma by plus sign. All remains as it is, and we got expression called as a regular expression. So what is the definition according to our TOC part? So the regular language and regular expression over summation. Now summation stands for a set of alphabets. Remember, summation is nothing but the set of alphabets, either it consists A, B, 0, 1, 5, etc.
So the summation symbol we have to use from here is our discussion part. Summation is nothing but the set of alphabets. So capital R is the regular language over the set of alphabet. Then the corresponding regular expression we have to define as follows. If phi means empty is an element of capital R, then regular expression is also phi. Second rule, if null strings or the null symbol is present into our regular language, then regular expression is also remains as it is. Now, so the first rule for our empty language, second rule is for our null language, and third rule is nothing but for the simple language that consists the alphabet over A, B and etc. Means the language consists the alphabets as A, B and its combination is an element of R, then the regular expression is A. Now, if L1 and L2 are any elements of R, R1 and R2 are the corresponding regular expression. Now we are selecting here the two regular languages, L1 and L2. And for that L1, there is a regular expression as R1. For the L2, there is an irregular expression as R2. Now, we have to define these, we have to define now by using the rule, operation part. If L1 union L2 element of R, means L1 and L2 is the part of our regular language, then this corresponding regular expression, we have to replace L1 by R1, L2 by R2, and we have to replace U symbol or comma symbol by plus, and we have to replace the curly brackets by round parenthesis, means R1 plus R2 in round parenthesis. This is our regular expression. Then L1, here is L1 L2, means we have to take as concatenation part, means L1 concatenation L2 is an part of R, then this regular expression is R1, R2, but we have to write into round parenthesis. Likewise, L1 star means the cleans operation. L1 star is an element of R, then the regular expression is L1, we have to replace by R1, and we have to make star as it is, but we have to write into round parenthesis. Remember one thing, that we have to keep R1 star in bracket here. It is not outside the bracket. Okay, so this is related to the regular expression. In the previous slide, we discussed about regular language. So this is our regular language. Already we discussed about it consists of three basic languages: null language, simple language, empty language, and three operations: union, concatenation, and the cleans. And this is related to our regular expression, means how we convert the regular expression by using regular language. So by simply leaving curly brackets by round parenthesis and union or comma by plus, we got expression called as the regular expression. And secondly, we discuss about how we define regular language over regular expression over regular language on a set of alphabets also. So in the exam, the question asks define regular language and regular expression, if theoretically there is. Now we have to discuss how we construct the regular language and regular expression of the given statement part here. Okay, so before that, okay, so already we discussed about what is the regular language and the regular expression by its theoretical part here. So regular language consists basically three basic languages: empty language, null language. So this null language we denote by the symbol. This is our null language. We define this null language by the null string like epsilon, or it consists the combination of the epsilon. Likewise here, and we delimit our language in open and closing brackets. Second language we discuss about empty language. This empty language consists either a phi symbol or we called opening and closing bracket. Don't put this epsilon in curly brackets here. It is not allowed here, because if we are putting this phi into this bracket, it becomes as likewise, it becomes this part, and it is nothing but it is a simple language. Okay, remember. And last part is nothing but the simple language. The simple language over our simple alphabet AB. How it is defined simple language? So simple language. We have to define that simple language over alphabets. A is our one alphabet. B is our second alphabet. Then AA is also become our one string. AB also another string. Then BB. Likewise, this language is endless language. So this language is nothing but the simple language, and we have to define that simple language over alphabets as A, B. Okay, so this is our simple language, as well as union, concatenation, and clincher. So union, we require the majorly two languages. Consider here language is L1. L1 consists element as 0, 1. And L2 consists element as 00, 10. So what is its L1 union L2? So L1 union L2 is equals to 0, 1 union, sorry, 0, 0, 1, 0. So what is this concatenation? So L1 concat L2. So remember one thing, that key union and concatenation requires the two languages here. So we have to write 0, 1 concat 10. So these are the concatenation. And now we have to make star, means consider we have to single another language as L3 language, and it consists as single element as a 0. Okay, so how we have to make it clean here? Remember one thing, that we have to apply 0 star here. It is a star here. So how we convert that 0 star into language part? So the first element of this is epsilon. Remember one thing, that epsilon means null. Then second element 0, third element is 00, fourth element is 000. Likewise, repetitively we have to write as infinite. It is the clean part. So secondly, there is also star plus symbol here. So this plus symbol just omits this epsilon, means it starts from the 0 onwards, same is 00, 000, up to infinite. So this is our clean. This is our clean part here. Okay. So now we have to discuss about how we prove the given formula here. 1 star is equals to 1 star is equals to 1 star. LHS is equals to RHS. So how it is possible? So first we have to show LHS, means we have to calculate the LHS part. So LHS is our 1 star, means LHS part is 1 star. Second 1 star means in between these two, it will be concatenation. Okay, let we have to start 1 star LHS part, 1 star epsilon 1 double 1 up to infinite. So it is our 1 star. We have to also calculate 1 star again, because second component of our LHS part is also 1 star epsilon 1 double 1 up to infinite. So we have to make the concatenation of these two languages. So how it is possible? So 1 star is equals to, so it is our the first, it is our the second. So we have to select the first alphabet and make concatenation with its all the alphabets here, means double epsilon, epsilon 1, epsilon double 1. Okay, up to infinite because this is the concatenation. Then second component, 1, we have to make concatenation with, it's all 1 1 1 1 1 1 up to infinite. Likewise, we have to take third alphabet or the string we call and make its concatenation. Means 1 1 epsilon 1 1 1 4 times 1 up to infinite. So this is the language. In this language consists all these strings, and we have to make the concatenation. This is the final result of the concatenation of these two languages here. So getting or not, we have to make concatenation of these strings to these strings of second languages. How it is possible? We have to select the first strings of the first language and make the concatenation, means first string of second language. Then first string of first language, we have to concat the second string of second language, first string of first language, third string of second language. Likewise, we have to create the strings here. Now we have to select the second element of the first language, first element of the second language, second element of the first language, second element of the second language. Likewise, we have to create the strings, and it is our final answer. So just we have to simplify it. So double epsilon becomes single epsilon. Epsilon once, 1. 2 times epsilon, here is epsilon. Epsilon 1, double epsilon. 1 epsilon, 1 already we are taken here. Double epsilon taken here. Triple time 1. Double epsilon, double 1 already we are taken here. Triple time 1 already taken here. Now 4 times 1. And remaining as it is. So it is our LHS part here. This is our LHS part. Now what about RHS? RHS part in our proof, I think that RHS is 1 star here. So what is the 1 star? I think that key, you people got answer. 1 star means simple, we have to make the star means epsilon 1, double 1, triple time 1, means we have to repetitively write here 4 times 1 up to infinite. So it is R1 star here. So here is our we have to write here A, here is our B, and final answer means final we have to write here from A and B, we have tried LHS is equals to IHS, means it is our proof part here. Getting or not? So such a type of example asked into our exam. So we have to solve number of questions in the tutorial sessions. But remember one thing, that how we show LHS is equal to IHS. We have to take another example for that. Second part is nothing but find the regular language and regular expression of the corresponding to each of the following subset of 0, 1 star. Means here is we have to given 0 and 1 alphabet. Means by using that 0, 1 alphabet and its claims, means repeatedly we have to call here. We have to construct regular language and regular expressions. Means it is our second outcome. Already we discussed that key. After the discussion or after the this lecture, second outcome is you people have to construct the regular language and regular expression of the given statement. So here is the given statement as a strings ending with a 0. So strings ending with 0, for that statement we have to construct regular language and regular expression. How it is? So let. So the given part is nothing but, given part is a 0, 1 star, and we have to construct a regular language for the same. And you will are known that how we construct the regular expression by using regular language. So later we have to discuss how we construct the regular language. So Simple. The logic is that each and every strings having end symbol as a zero. Starting is in, means either 0, 1, epsilon, nothing. But each and every string should be end with 0. Means end with 0 here. Yeah. Okay. So, means the language is likewise 0. Then double 0 is also becomes part. Then 10 is also our part. 100 also becomes part. 010 also part. Likewise, the string is our language. So each and every strings end with 0, 0. Okay. So now question arises: which string is not part of our language? The strings likewise. 11, 101, 1001. Means each and every string having its end with 1. So these strings is not part of our language here, because we have to create the strings which are end with only 0. Means the first strings of our language is 0. Then 00, 10, 10, 10, 10, 10. Okay. So it is our language here. So how we simplified this language? So each and every strings end with a 0 means 0 is our end. So before the strings, any alphabet is here, means either 0, either 1, or it's clean symbol, means it consists either 0, sorry, either it consists either 0 or means union, we have write by using comma or union symbol, or 1 means before the 0, either 0 or 1 or its combination. The combination we perform by operation as a clean symbol. So simple now. Each and every string end with 0 and starting either 0, either 1 or its combination. Its combination means we have to make like a 0, 0. We have to concat that 0, 0 with 0. Okay. Likewise, second string will become as 10. So I just solve this by briefly, like 0, 1 means likewise 0, 1. 0, 1. How we perform this language? 0, 1. Star means epsilon, either 0, either 1, or the combinations 0, 0, 1, 1, triple time 0, triple time 1. Likewise, the strings are present into this language, and here is a single part, is nothing but 0. Means here is a 0. Okay, so we have to make concatenation of this. Means the first alphabet, our first language, we have to concat with this. Means we got final language is likewise epsilon 0, then 0, 0, then 10, then 000. Likewise, the strings is part of our final language. Final language of our this means 0, 1, *0. So this is final language of this regular language, means simplification regular language. So in that, each and every string ending with 0. So it is our regular language for our given statement part. The given statement part, string ending with 0, and the each and every string end with 0. Before the 0, it consists either 0, either 1, either null, or the combinations of the same. Getting or not? So this is the regular language. So the regular language is likewise of the string ending with 0. String ending with 0, regular language is 0, 1, means it starts from the 0 or 1 or the combinations of the same, but it ends with 0. So it is our regular language. So how it is a regular expression? Simply we have to remove these round parentheses bar. So not 1 minute, 1 minute. So the regular language, we have to write here curly brackets, confusion. So we have to simply remove these curly brackets by round parentheses. First alphabets as it is, we have to replace one by plus, sorry, comma by plus, and this we have to write one as it is, star as it is, and the zero. So it becomes as regular expression. So for the given statement, it is our first question. For the given statement, the regular language and regular expression same way. So what is the answer? So first, you people have to create a regular language for the given statement by writing all the strings, means epsilon 0, epsilon 0, 1 0, 1 0 0. Likewise, you have to write the strings and it becomes as our regular language. And after that, you have to write simplification origin of regular language and write as a regular language is equals to starting our part 01 or its combinations and 0 as it is. And then you people have to write a regular expression. Regular expression simple as 0 plus 1 means we have to eliminate or replace curly brackets by curly brackets by around parenthesis, comma by plus, all it is remains same. So this is our answer part of first statement. According to you people have to try solve these or write the strings ending with 1, string ending with 1 1, and strings ending of the even length. So you people have to try to find out regular language and regular expression of strings ending with 1, strings ending with 1 1, strings of the even length. Okay, if any doubt, please feel free to contact. Okay, at least you have to try to find out regular language and regular expression of string ending with 1, string ending with 1 1, strings of the even length. Okay, thank you. Have a nice day.